the predator only grew stronger.
Have you ever sat and thought what you would get if you mixed Monkey Journey to the West with Mad Max, Honey I Shrunk the Kids, Devil May Cry, and your pet gerbil? Well, wonder no more, as Biomutant is the answer. This post-apocalyptic third-person open-world kung fu adventure is nothing if not unique. From picking your build and breed, which looks a little like the morphing effect from the 90s, just much hairier, to crafting your own weapons and learning new wushu skills, this tale of eco-destruction is devoid of humans, but has a distinct Chinese fable throughout. As you seek out new territories, make friends and foes, you evolve and expand your skills, mixing gun and sword combat into a flurry of action. Or is that furry of action? The only thing missing is a Wu-Tang Clan theme song. I'm sure that can be added in DLC. The Swedish team behind this fable, Experimental 101, jumped ship from Avalanche Studios and Just Cause in 2015, and this is the product of their labour. The game has picked Unreal Engine 4 as its chosen tool for the job, and today we are going to look at the best consoles can offer in the Series S, the X and the PS5, with a little slice of Xbox One X and Pro just for those last gen samples. It's important for context of this title. So let's talk about the performance then. It has two options in the menu on every single format, it seems. 30fps or 60fps is your poison, pick what you want.
Now, all tested versions here support this mode. You can go between 30 to 60 FPS. But from visual checking, aside from changes to the sharpening filter, the only version that seems to benefit significantly from this is the Xbox Series S. But more on that in a moment. So looking at the PlayStation 5 and the Series X, what are we getting? Well, this is the first surprise. The game targets 60 FPS on both these versions. Again, you can make it 30, but it does a pretty decent job overall to hit 60. But it runs in a backwards compatibility format on both machines. But as the solution for Xbox is very different and more inherent to a PC solution in terms of its overall construction, then they gain a benefit from utilizing the hardware much better. And this transpires in the overall game here quite significantly. So the first thing is the PS5 version targets 1920 by 1080p fixed, and that's it. That's its output. It outputs at 1080p. The Series X, on the other hand, targets an output resolution of 3840 by 2160, but it reaches this with a base resolution of 1920 by 1080p. And this is using Unreal Engine 4's temporal anti-aliasing upsample, TAAU. This means that the base geometry itself, the buffer, is drawn at the lower bounds, that 1920 by 1080, and then it's upsampled using that temporal reconstruction data, previous frames merged together to reconstruct the image. This can leave artifacts a little like checkerboard. And then the motion blur, the bloom, all that other elements, tone mapping, post effects, alphas, they're all added on top at the higher resolution, which puts much more strain on the engine, but it outputs with a cleaner, sharper image than if you just upsample from that 1080p base. And this is evident in the game. It's a sharper, cleaner image, certainly, but it's not all down to resolution deltas. That upsampling technique from Unreal Engine 4 is very good. It does a great job here to improve the image quality from that same base 1080p. This is similar to how Destin covered it in Returnal earlier this month. But over and above this, the Series X has a better image quality, not just because of resolution, that's probably not even the biggest part, it's because the details, the textures, the assets, they're all better on the Series X. It's a better version because it has a bigger footprint, it's a 2GB larger game installed, so that's the texture assets are better, the LOD is better, the shadow cascade is further out, it's drawing more foliage more often, everything's more dense, you can see it here, but also decals and textures on the floor are missing on the PS5 and obviously the PS4 Pro. Pro, because you can see it on that area around the ground where I've zoomed in, you can see that moss and grass is missing. It's just not as detailed. There's rocks missing, there's detail missing throughout, and the PS5 is just a lower quality version than the Series X because it's inherently just running the PS4 Pro version, nothing more than that. The Series X is inherently running the Xbox One X version, but the team can do a little more due to the GDK solution they've got in the Xbox development cycle to utilize that hardware a little better. Both versions are not native consoles.
console versions on the Series X and PS5. They're not taking full advantage of the consoles, but in the Series X backwards compatibility, it does a easier job for the team and therefore enables them to use it better. And we're seeing the fruits of Microsoft labor here in a title such as this, which runs pretty well even at that additional level of output. But overall, the image quality is not a huge difference between the two. It's not, resolution doesn't make that much of a difference. It's definitely better on a 4K screen. But as I've just said, the texture details and the assets, the additional LOD, all of those things make a bigger difference on the image quality than just resolution alone. Now, the Series S is similar. Now, that isn't running the same solution. Like I say, the Xbox One X is exactly the same. It's 1920 by 1080p, and then it targets 3840 by 2160 using that temporal anti-aliasing. The Series S doesn't look to be using the same version. It looks to be using the spatial upscale one later in the pipeline, and that means that you get much blurrier details across the board running in that 60 FPS mode. It also means the base is lower. It's no longer targeting 1080p here. It targets 1280 by 720. On the Series S, and then temporarily upsamples that back to that 4K. But because it's done in the cheaper, later pipeline solution, everything looks more dithered, more noisy, much blurrier. And that really transpires through a much worse looking title than any other version I've looked at, obviously aside the Series Xbox One S, but I haven't covered that in this title. So I would recommend you play this in the 30 FPS mode, because that pushes it back to the same solution, a 1920 base, and then pushes that back up to 3840. And all that detail comes back, and you can see examples of that compared to the other versions on screen. It also has a lower LOD on the Xbox One X than every other version. The Series S does fall somewhere between the PS5 and the Series X. But overall, the image quality is very good. What is a problem for the overall title, though, is texture quality, details and assets, and some of the animation can be a little clunky and stand out with lower quality mipmaps in certain sections when you're close to the camera, and obviously a bit of a mishmash in terms of the texture quality decals on the floor everywhere, and every version, including the Series X, uses quite low anisotropic filtering. So in fact, it looks like on the PS4 Pro and the PS5, it might even be using something like bilinear or trilinear filtering. I'm not too sure, but it's definitely not very clean, it's not very sharp, and at bleak angles across the ground, which you can see examples of the consoles here, it can look very blurry and very messy. It's a good looking game in terms of light, shadow, cascade, it's a very vibrant, bright title, but it certainly doesn't look anything like a next generation title because the assets are quite low, but it is a very small independent team. That is not its target.
Talking of targets, let's move to performance. So all versions could cap at 30 and be pretty consistent. That much is out of the way. But here we're going to look at the 60 FPS mode. So the PS5 and the Series X both have hiccups. They generally have issues in traversal. So CPU issues, hiccups, stuttering, RAM allocation, all those kind of standard instantiation and context switch issues can crop up on every version, irrespective of the format. It's much worse than that older generation. But the PS5 and the Series X both can dip into the 50s, but as you would expect, the PS5 is better than the Series X. Not by a long chalk, there's not a huge amount in it, but it will definitely dip more often on the Series X in combat and alpha and graphical effects than it will on the PS5, but they can both stutter and judder when streaming data in, and sometimes I think it's worse on the PS5 on this. You get some longer hiccups into 66 milliseconds, 50 milliseconds on both consoles. It can, like I say, it can go over 100 milliseconds on the last generation. But in combat, you can get these stutters and dropping down to 50, low 50s at certain points. Lowest I got on the Series X was 48, lowest I got on the PS5 was 50. That's just luck of the draw, I think. They both consistently dip in certain points in the title. I must stress this again, this is not native on running on both consoles, it's just backwards compatibility. So this isn't inherent of the overall hardware itself, so don't turn it into that, but this is definitely an issue that needs to be remediated. And generally, there's issues in the game overall, optimization, quote, quote, that needs to be done across some elements of the engine, like I say, traversal, allocations, context switching. They're the main areas that I can see in some of the things in the performance hiccups we're getting. Longer hangs on last generation, much more consistent, much shorter 33 millisecond spikes on the newer generation. So the hardware does help because it drives the performance a little better, but overall, if it's going to dip, it's dipping slightly more on the Series X than it is on the PS5, but like I say, there's not a great deal in it, and overall, performance is okay, but it's far from perfect. For traversal, running around the world, streaming things in, that's where you'll feel a lot of the juddering and stuttering as you move around, but it's more consistent. consistent and much more performant on the new generation consoles. So these are definitely the preferred way to play it. And overall, the Series X is the better version because the image quality is better and performance is nigh on identical between that and the PlayStation 5.
So moving things along to the Xbox One X and the Series S. As we just discussed, those deltas aside, the performance is worse on the X overall because it skips and judders far more often due to those streaming issues, memory allocation issues, and CPU bound issues generally. That's the biggest problem here. That said, the S is so nowhere near a 60 FPS even at this level. It still consistently skips into 33 milliseconds, hovering somewhere around the 40s far too often, and traversing the world can just feel inconsistent on both, but far worse on the Xbox One X. Into combat, it can flip-flop. Any GPU bound section at this point is better on the X, as you can see here in this cutscene, than it is on the S. But once you're actually doing anything, it's generally slightly better on the S than it is on the X. It really isn't a great performing title on these both of these consoles, and I would recommend you cap them both to 30. It looks and runs better on the S at that level. At least it's more consistent, but it certainly looks better because all that dithering and issues that I've just covered goes away. And on the Xbox One X, it just performs more to the target it can achieve. And that's the same for the Pro. The Pro, it can hold 60 at points, but again, traversing the world or having combat, it judders and skips far, far too often for it to be a recommended mode, even on the PlayStation 4 Pro, which fundamentally is exactly the same quality and image at 1080p base, no temporal upscale to 4K, as we're seeing on the PS5. They are the same version, same lot, everything else. It just performs worse, and therefore that 30 FPS option is needed. And the final piece of that comparison jigsaw is those all important loading times. And again, we are seeing another significant delta here in the Series X and the Series S over the PlayStation 5. Just reinforcing results we've covered elsewhere in the title, with the Series S being the fastest of the lot. Obviously, it's got less texture slightly, so it's very close to 12.5 seconds. And then almost 100% slower is the PS5 at 21 seconds. And then bringing up the rear is the Xbox One X, with its last generation throughput, last generation CPU and hard drive coming in at 50 seconds. The game isn't a big loader, but when you do come back from the save point, that 50 seconds versus 12 makes a big difference. And that draws to a close another deep dive into the most prevalent console versions in the Xbox Series S, PS5, and even those last generation versions of Biomutant. If you like this and all things gaming and technology related, then keep it IGN.com, IGN.games, and I'll catch you on the next one.
Through fire and water to make it out of here.